A very good afternoon to you all. Amidst this pandemic situation, today, we at Surendranath College plan to engage your mind in a very interesting world of graphology. As a speaker had already requested, hope you are all ready with 1.5 pages of your own handwriting and your signature. So let's see what our handwriting says about us. Now, I would request our principal, Dr. Indranil Kaur, to deliver the inaugural address. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Aditi. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Graphology is the analysis of physical characteristics and pattern of handwriting supposed to identify the writer, indicating his or her psychological state at the time of writing or evaluating personal characteristics. This is generally considered as a scientific reference for forensic document examination. Though graphology sometimes used to be controversial, but recent analysis and development surely shows that the science of graphology definitely has a bearing on the general psychological and behavioral pattern of an individual. It is understood that this method definitely helps in correction of individual's character and personality traits by making a few simple changes made in their handwriting pattern. Now, graphology is regularly being used by the corporate sector before employment. Thus, this subject becomes an important, very important, I should say, in today's world. Today we have Mr. Mohan Ghosh with us, who is an exponent in graphology. He is the founder of an institute, and definitely he is the expert in this area of science of handwriting. I would request Deepasri to introduce the speaker to the audience. Over to you, Deepasri.
Thank you, sir. Very good afternoon, everybody. Today, we have with us Mr. Mohan Bose, director and founder of Kolkata Institute of Graphology, and he will deliver a lecture on introduction to graphology and its implication in society. Mr. Mohan Bose is a practicing graphologist for more than 28 years. Mr. Bose established Kolkata Institute of Graphology in the year 2002. He is the main faculty of the graphology courses and also faculty of PG diploma in family counseling affiliated to University of Calcutta. He has trained Indian defense personnel for combating suicidal and worrying crimes. He has also trained numerous mental health medical professionals, educators, and researchers in the field of graphology. He is the author of a number of books, including Handwriting Guidebook for Parents and Teachers, Research Methodology and Psychology of Graphology, Robindranath Hastolipir Bicharu Bisleshan in Bangla, Graphology, An Insight into One Capabilities, and Handwriting Analysis for Beginners. With this short introduction, I would like to invite Mr. Bose to deliver his lecture. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, the team Surendranath College. And I welcome all the participants to this amazing world of graphology. Today, I will speak on this subject in a very nutshell because there is a time limit. And without wasting much time, let us introduce the subject graphology first. The literary meaning of graphology means it is graph and ology, where graph means the writing or stroke pattern, and ology means analysis or chemistry or science. It means that in handwriting analysis, our subject is not what you are writing, but how it is written. A whole one page of handwriting has its various facets, we split the handwriting into its parts, and each part indicate certain traits. And as a whole, after analyzing each traits, the parts, we assemble the whole and find the personality type of the person. Now, the amazing range of this analysis is, it's not only that your behavioral pattern reflects in the writing, but also diseases, and starting from migraine to cancer, all these reveals in the handwriting. But what makes handwriting analysis scientific? Leave aside the handwriting analysis. Come to the handwriting. There are many researches which shows that although we write with our hand, but actually the pattern of writing originate from the brain, the cerebral cortex, and the process is actually the motoric process, because handwriting is a fine motor skill. All of you appreciate one thing, that any behavioral pattern or any behavior that we do in our everyday life is fundamentally a movement, be it the very minor movement or be it a gross movement. A minor tick on the cheek or a lip movement or the hand movement or even the eyeball movement, all are fundamentally the movement pattern that indicate our behaviors and emotions. And this movement pattern originate from the brain. Assuming look at the board, if we understand that this is a brain, there is a part called motor cortex. That is, the motor cortex is here. And the motor cortex fundamentally responsible to deliver all movement pattern. Those who know about the brain functions, they will appreciate the point that motor cortex fundamentally regulate the physical movement, be it the hand, be it the lip, or be it the eyeball movement, or be it the finger movement, yes. But motor cortex itself do not regulate and display my overt or covert behavior unless motor cortex is instructed by the other departments of the brain or the parts of the brain. And that is why motor cortex is linked to almost every part of the brain, including emotion, sequence, grammar, language, your defenses, your projection. Every departmental part of the brain is linked with the motor cortex. Now what happens? When you are excited, the emotion linked with the motor cortex, and accordingly motor cortex deliver a movement pattern, either in form of pleasure or in form of anger. When you are depressed, the inhibited emotional state, there is a psychomotor retardation. That means there is some inhibiting movement pattern we see in our daily life. So while writing also, as writing originates from the motor cortex, writing also catch all these emotional state, and accordingly the motor cortex form my graphic gestures. Due to this, although all of us taught writing in a fixed manner, but none of us write as we are taught. We depart from writing norms. For example, imagine all of us are taught initially on a four-ruled paper that this why. But now, if you see your handwriting, a few people have this proportionate Y. We have departed this Y and started writing long, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. And there are so many forms of Y. Now, if I ask you, when you have shifted from this Y to this Y, you will not be able to tell. Because this each departure from writing norms are individually conditioned and appears in the writing much beneath the threshold of your consciousness. So you do not know when you have departed from the writings. It actually, as your behavior started emerging, your writing started changing. And in these changes, there are different layers. One, there is a change that occurs after a long period of time. There are changes, those occur day to day. There are changes which occur moment to moment. So, in spite of that, there are changes in the handwriting. It doesn't bar a graphologist to identify you. Because graphologists know that these changes occur day to day. So this is a moment to moment emotional state. This occur time to time, and this is his fixed character. So different parts of handwriting is our subject matter, where actually our focus is to identify who are you. Now, the scientific evidences of graphology is that when we call a subject science only and only when the inferences those are drawn after analysis must be consistent and standardized. And so graphology is. I will show some evidences. For example, if you collect water sample, whenever and wherever you collect water sample, always you will get that there is a hydrogen and oxygen. So, irrespective of the area of operation, when we find that all water sample contain hydrogen and oxygen, we call this method is consistent, and so it is chemistry, a science. In graphology also, in psychology also, worldwide the depressions, the core problem is that there is a psychomotor retardation. So irrespective of the area of operation, if the clinical symptom shows psychomotor retardation and some series of behavioral patterns similar, we call the person is in depression. Similarly, in handwriting analysis also. Suppose in handwriting analysis, any Y, as I told, this Y. Anyone write this Y, whether he is a Canadian, Australian, or Calcuttan, will be the same character element. So this process is scientific. Second, any science has its own historical evolution, and graphology has also its historical evolution from rudimentary stage to the scientific level. Third, any science has its own research history. Graphology has also tens of thousands of researches which are done by psychiatrists, neurophysiologists, physiology professors, or scientists also. And who knew graphology, some of them are Newton, Einstein, Freud, Jung, and even Shakespeare. Evidences and evidences are there Even the great discoverer of IQ tests, Alfred Binet, who had researched on this subject and came to a conclusion that this is a science of future, graphology. Graphology not only decipher the behavioral pattern, but diseases too. You go to net, you type American Cancer Research Society 1950. Dr. Alfred Kenfar, he had chosen around 800 or 900 patients and their handwritings were analyzed, and out of them, 89 were suggested as cancer from handwriting analysis. And then they were sent for medical tests. It was seen that out of 89, 73 were confirmed cancer. Research is displayed in the net also. You can find it out. It was during 1890, Dr. Prayer, who was a professor of physiology, he chosen a group of people whose both hands were amputated. And he trained them to write with their toe. After a year of initial training was over and they started habitual writing by their toe, was seen that their earlier handwriting is same as their toe writing. So he came to the conclusion, his subject of research was that brain and handwriting. And he wrote a book on this, and ultimately he derived a conclusion that although we write with our hand, but handwriting or toe writing or teeth writing, it is irrespective, because the impulse that the motor cortex deliver, accordingly my stroke pattern forms. So I depart from the norms of writing. For example, worldwide, no school teaches us to write in the backslant. But person, you will see many a writer, even maybe present today's class also. If you write in the backslant like this, backslanted writing, they suppress their feelings. They cannot express easily. They have a few selective friends. And there are so many. So it takes us 1 second time to understand what is the emotional state. And irrespective of the area of operation, whether this is written by a Canadian, Calcuttan, or Australian, the emotional state, the character will be the same. And they have, as I told, they have a few selective friends, they can remain alone. They are profound thinkers. Again, if we find some people write vertically, many of you, your handwriting is now with you, you will appreciate that some people write vertically. Like this, vertically. On the line, they place the letters vertically. Those who write vertically, immediately we understand that they always suffer from taking a decision. That is approach and avoidance. Bolbo ki bolbo na, korbo ki korbo na. Er moddhe dolayoman thake. And mostly their interest will be intellectual interest. And very on a light note, if they go for shopping, eta jokhon shopping korte jay, eta jinish ta ki kinbe age thik kore jay, ebong seta pelei kene na. Eta age tar quality dekhbe. And then ask for the price. So the choice, quality, and price, if the head gives the signal, then only they will purchase it. Otherwise, bolega bhaiya rakh do, main thoda dusra dukaan dekh ke aata. Because why it is? Because irrespective of the area they live in, their every activities are controlled by the head, not by the heart. Now you tell me how much time, you will appreciate that, how much time I need to read you. How you express your emotions, how you deal with the others, what is your shopping style, etc., etc., on a lighter note. And on a very serious note, these people, if want to be indifferent to you, within second they can be indifferent. They even will not look back the second moment. I will invite questions also, whether my interpretations you will find difficult to understand or not. But I'm giving you, because here the subject matter is not what you have written. Now look, you will appreciate why motor delivered the behavioral pattern. Look at the board. I am writing same words in three ways. Now handwriting, you will appreciate that when I write, my hand moves from this side. This side, my hand moves. Now if I write A-R-E-R, and if I write A-R-E-R, and if I write A-R-E-R, and if I ask you, in this movement pattern, who is in a hurry? You will answer that the first one. Who is moving comfortably? The second one. Who is finding difficult in the movement pattern? The third one. What I have written? A-R-E-R. Now what you are reading? The behavioral pattern. That hurry, comfortable, or in fear. And because I told handwriting originate from the motor cortex. And motor cortex, as instructed by different parts of the brain, accordingly motor cortex deliver that movement patterns, impulses to my finger. It passes through the central nervous system to the peripheral nervous system, and ultimately the movement pattern creates myself. And I am not aware of the movement pattern because my focus is on the subject of the writing. Even if you try to control the movement pattern, you will be caught as you are covering something. So absolutely perfect writing is a sign of mask. Generally, we understand that handwriting means a spontaneous writing, because the fundamental purpose of handwriting is to communicate. And we have three types of expressive behaviors. One is talk, second is gesture, and third is handwriting. And out of the three, handwriting is the most sustainable evidence that gives us extra benefit. Someone criticizes about graphology not as a science, most probably they have not entered into this field. As if you ask me about chartered accountancy, I cannot opine. I should not, rather, because I do not know the subject, how much it is correct or not. But whoever has learned graphology, they know the depth of this science. It is a projective psychological tool. My movement pattern is my projection of behaviors. And one page handwriting helps us to understand at least 300 to 400 traits with n number of fallout. Now there are different layers. Handwriting has an added advantage to read, because when we talk of motor cortex, in the motor cortex, our whole body is recorded in the motor cortex in somatotopical form. That means my head is next to my throat, then the chest is next to my throat. Yeah, chest is next to my throat like that, downward. So when the handwriting moves any parts, if there is some pain, there is some deformity, there is some neurological disease that reflects in the handwriting. That is why from migraine to cancer, everything displayed in the handwriting with 99% accuracy. And unbelievable for a person who has not entered into this field. And in the psychological layer, we have already created a host of psychological tools, and internationally also it was developed long before. We can diagnose depression within 2-3 minutes. Anxiety disorder, obsessional neurosis, bipolar, panic disorder, impulse control disorder, schizophrenia, and so many. And only in one country, you will believe it or not, only in Germany for last 100 years, 50 PhD theses are successfully concluded on graphology and disease. That means one PhD in 2 years, only in Germany. Since 2004 to 2019, in Calcutta University, in master degree program, 7 dissertations were successfully concluded in the psychology department and human development department. Same is in the Christ University also. This year, 2 doctoral program is nearly completing. One is in Gujarat Forensic Science, where 150 convicted under 203, that is murder, their handwritings were collected from Sabarmati jail. They had written in Gujarati. Because graphology is not script biased. Because the subject is here, the how it is written. Suppose you write Y like this, and in Hindi you write A like this, to, and in Bengali you write A like this. For a graphologist, this stroke is our concern. And that is coming down, taking left turn, coming down, taking left turn, coming down, taking left turn. So it is how it is written, irrespective of the script. So they entrusted me to develop ASPD scale, antisocial personality disorder scale. We developed it by graphological assessment and correlated with their psychological assessment of their criminal character. And amazingly, it was quoted, and now it is waiting for the final approval this year. In Calcutta University this year, one of our students who is in doctoral program on graphology, the first PhD thesis will be concluded by 2021 in Calcutta University and 2021 in Gujarat Forensic Science. Yes, this is a tool, like psychological tool, graphology got impetus more and more with the emergence of psychology from the young science to a mature science, and so graphology also. It was in 1905, Dr. Mayer, who was a psychiatrist, he chosen a group of people suffering from manic depressive bipolar disorder. He collected their handwriting when they were in manic state and collected their handwriting when they were in depressed state. It was seen that their handwritings were different when they were in manic state than when they were in depressed state. Handwriting changes. Like this, all we were taught in a fixed manner. Again, I am coming. When the 4-rule paper were given, initially we were asked to write completing the full size of the middle case O and A like that. Extending this is D. Extending this is G, like that. But as we grew, we depart from this school model and formal training. We developed our individuality. And someone of you started reducing the writing to a tiny one. This small, a tiny size. Even today, whoever writes in this tiny size, you will appreciate that you behave in an introvert manner and find very difficulty to be in the group in a massive scale. Rather, you feel comfortable when you work alone and isolatedly. And more the smaller the size will be, more you are running a risk to be compulsive. So if any pain you get, you are hurt by someone, you go for self-torture instead of releasing it out. Any small writer will engage into the self-torture compulsively. Now this character, identification of this character was developed after tens of thousands of samples empirically concluded and the inferences became common. And thus now the inferences become a law, a rule. So like any other science, the rule in graphology also developed through series of experiments. In our institute, Kolkata Institute of Graphology, very recent, we have developed after hundreds of experiments in this year that handwriting also reveals vitamin D deficiency. It sounds like magic, but it is not magic because we behave and behavior is a movement. Handwriting is also a movement, a behavior. That is the fundamental task of handwriting is to communicate. So my purpose of communication, my ideas, my thoughts, my feelings through the writing. But while writing, the way I write appears behind the threshold of my conscious awareness. That is why each person when write, I go, suppose a person writes, I go, another person writes, I go, another person writes, I go. You are not aware that while writing in the movement, how much space between two words you have left. So this living space between two words, your individual property, and emerge from your unconscious layer. And we can read you immediately. The person who has a habit to write narrow space between two words, they are highly social. They always need people around him. As if they write in a very narrow space. I go to school every day like that. So the spaces are narrow. But the person who gives a wide space between two lines, they are choosy in mixing with others. So they have a wide space like that. So this individuality, this is individuality. And this is reflected in the handwriting. Not only this is the writing structure we understand. Even the moment you start writing on a page, look at your own handwriting sample. Any one of you who has started very narrow, your writing line is here, margin line, very narrow to the left end, very narrow. You see whether it is less than 1/2 inch or 2 millimeters, or 3 centimeters like that, very narrow. All of you who are present in this class, all of you have been suffering from emotional trouble. And yes, you know what are those troubles from the past, and you are carrying those. And by nature, it is a neurotic character. That means you are aware of your problem, but you cannot come out of your problem. Very narrow. So like that, I am giving you tips of the iceberg, you can say. Graphology is a vast subject. And one page handwriting unbelievably tells your willpower, endurance, your risk-taking ability, your introversion, your extroversion, your friendship, making friendship quality, your relationship with your spouse, your relationship with your mother, parents, everything, everything. And another layer, all the psychological irregularities. Are you a constricted personality? Are you an overexcited and manic personality? Are you manic depressive? Are you obsessive? Are you hysteric? Say, if you come across any handwriting where the writing cannot be read, and you find a thread and thread in the handwriting, like this. Ask them. They will not accept, but read them, understand them. They will not accept. They will say everything is normal. But they are hysteric. They are engaged in the unbearable emotional trouble. A hysteric type, the thready writing. It takes us seconds to read where the strengths are and where the weaknesses are. And that is the highest benefit in graphology, that it can help as a self-diagnostic tool. I can understand where am I going wrong? Why am I confused? Why am I not being able to relate with my partner or spouse? Why am I not being able to crack the exam? Why am I lacking concentration? Why am I lacking concentration? And any person who wants to come out of silly mistake or spelling mistakes, if you just put the I dot above, you can, it is very difficult to put the dot above the I. And those who does silly mistake and spelling mistake, that I dots are random. That is sometimes here, random I dot. So like that we understand and we rectify. Here the added advantage is the graphology is not only a diagnostic tool, it's a therapeutic tool also. We have been rectifying thousands of people coming out from their, taking out from their problems, be it the emotional problem, be it the study problem, lack of concentration, attention in details, be it a trauma, be it the suicidal. Presently I'm counseling 4 suicide prone couple, 1 partner in the couple. They are suicidal during this corona stage. Because handwriting reveals that reactive depression and suicide. Even last time that Sushant Singh's handwriting was, I was asked to analyze Sushant's handwriting. And it was revealed that. It was then displayed in ABP Anand Bazar and other Hindi paper also. So graphology can identify suicide prone person or a person who has committed suicide, the source of it. Even much before a person commits suicide, the handwriting evidence illuminates in the writing. And so it helps us to understand this person is losing hope to live very fast. So we have a greater advantage to cure the person, and we have been doing it. You may ask that when handwriting identify cancer, identify migraine, gastric ulcer, blood pressure, blood sugar, lipid profile, thyroid, gallstone, joint pain, then why it is not in the medical science? because it is not taken in the medical science, because it doesn't carry any industrial interests. That means graphology is an individual skill-based diagnosis, not an X-ray machine that has an industrial output, bulk production. So where industrial interests are there, those parts of the discoveries were championed. Thousands other even dumped. But it is not your measuring area that a science is to be industrialized always, a science for the human always. So it can be individually served also. Anyone can learn this science and can be benefited. And not only writing, it also display the signature also too much. Now see, so those who have a tendency to write full name and surname, suppose Sumit Roy, full name as signature. You will appreciate that this person will always enhance his own rights, what I should get. So a couple where both write full name. So Sumit Roy and the wife is Sunita Roy. If both write this, any one of you, your family, both of you write full name in your signature, your family structure fundamentally is based on live and let live policy. Because both will have and will exercise their own rights. Own rights. So their existence in the family will be live and let live without disturbing the other's right. Now someone who writes only S. Roy. Now he will definitely have a self-sacrificing character. So one is S. Roy, other is R. Roy other is Mr. is S. Roy and Mrs. is suppose Sunita Roy. So he has to exist in the unit by sacrificing. And she will exercise the rights. If the reverse, then the man will exercise the rights, she will sacrifice. Sacrifice. Now it is not that it is his choice he has written. Yes, apparently it is his choice. But choice originates from the likings or dislikings. How I want to project myself. The name is the individual identity. And that is how the representation has its own relationship with the mental state. Own relationship with the mental state. Person who gives double dot, even S. Roy, even giving an underscore and give double dot. They are socially very comfortable. Yes. But if someone writes, so there are different facets. When someone writes name and surname overlaps, suppose S. Roy, or B, or suppose Haripado, H, and Roy, R-O-Y. Both this person will have a conflict with their mother figure. They cannot reach to common opinion. But when opinion clash, if mother says ki aaj rajma chawal hoga, to beta jodur bolega nahi aaj khichdi hoga. It's just like that on a lighter note. That means they cannot reach to one agreement. And interestingly now, if this S is a male and S Roy marry, S means Sumit. Now if Sumit writes like this and Sumit marries, whom he has married? Substitute of mother figure. So now the clash will be with the wife too. So Sumit will entangle into the clash with mother and clash with wife. on opinion clash. And as long as this signature will persist, they will not be able to come out of it. So actually, handwriting analysis is a vast subject. It is very difficult for me to entertain you within 40 minutes, 45 minutes, but still, I am introducing the subject in that manner. Person who press and write. When you write, if you press, any one of you, and if you observe that you have pressed so much that on the second page, the impression is seen. Any one of you whose handwriting is with you and there is a huge pressure, and if you move your finger on the backside of the page and find huge roughness, you are definitely a person who cannot forget if someone insulted you 10 years back or 20 years back even. You hold it. You have forgiven, but you did not forget that he has abused you or criticized or humiliated you. You cannot forget that. Then you know, this type of people are emotionally engaged with anything. And their working potential is very high. They can work at a stretch from 16, 17 hours. So my intention is to tell, when you are writing in a gist, that you write a subject for communication. Graphology, it is not required, what you are writing. Irrespective of the script you have chosen, well, how you write is our concern. And moment to moment, changes of emotion is so, so accurate. Even suppose if you write someone whom you hate, but your communication is, I like you very much. I like you very much. But actually, you hate him. So this word you will change. But if you really like him, you will be written differently. And within second, we understand whether actually you like or not. And so while teaching in the classroom, we often ask to bring your closest friend's handwriting or your fiancé's handwriting and ask him to write, "Darling, I love you very much." And then you review the case. What is the truth? Just on a, you know, you can enjoy the subject on a very lighter note. You can read the subject in a very deep layer where serious weaknesses can be understood. A person can understand his exact strengths and weaknesses both and can channelize the life. Some people are comfortable in group. Some people are comfortable working alone. So you can choose what type of occupation, what type of profession you are best, what type of partner you need to get. What is your limitations, etc., etc. And on the other side, if you have any negativity or any depression or any anxiety problem or any suspicion problem or any panic trigger, you can not only identify by changing the writing pattern, you can rectify yourself. My time is over. I know that it's very difficult for me to satisfy all of you, but I introduce the application of graphology. Number one, it is a projective tool to identify mental strengths and weaknesses, to identify psychological disorders, to identify diseases. It uses in the recruitment field. It uses in the compatibility, in choosing the right career for right person. and a vast portion of implement of graphology is in the forensic too. In the forensic examination, graphology is a department there where it is used. Thank you all of you. If you now, I hand over to the team of Surendranath College, how to go about further. Thank you all of you.
Thank you, sir. You lived up to the topic. And yes, it was introduction to graphology and its use in society. So after your talk, now I know that I do let live my husband. Me and my husband do live and let live. And that
you got it. You got the taste.
Yes, I got the taste. And that I do forgive but not forget. So thank you, sir, for such an insightful talk. Now I would request my colleague, Dr. Proshonno Mondol of Department of Physics. He would be asking he would be acting as a moderator and asking questions which are in the chat box. Now over to you, Proshonno.
Thank you, Mr. Bose, for your excellent presentation on graphology. We are really enriched with your talk, sir. Participants have asked many questions. Sir, the first question is, what does graphology tell about those who are ambidextrous, who can write in both hands?
Sir, do not follow.
What does graphology tell about those people who are ambidextrous, who can write in both hands?
Both hands.
Yes, sir.
Both hands.
Yes, sir.
I could have displayed the sample, but presently I do not have. I had one student who can write simultaneously with both hands like this. Mohan, suppose. So simultaneously. And I could have shown the handwriting, which I often show in my classroom also, that both the handwriting are same.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Both the handwriting are same.
Shall I go for the next question now, sir?
Yes.
So the next question is, what about the people who can write in different handwritings? Can they hide their personality by doing so?
See, in a common man's eye, the word different handwriting may be, number one, where the changes occur are moment-to-moment changes. But the original structure of handwriting is same, which a common man's eye may not be able to identify, but graphologist can. Number two, it may be that a person can change his handwriting and write differently. Yes, we can understand that even if you try to write differently, the fundamental psychology of human is you cannot possess a behavior for longer period of time, which is necessarily not your own behavior. That is why you are caught in a continuous interrogation. You cannot hide ultimately. Similarly, you can manipulate first some lines, but your originality will appear as you will submerge into the content of writing, your originality will appear. So within for a few seconds or for a few minutes, you can hide, but ultimately you cannot. So your originality displays in the handwriting, whatever changes you occur. That is why no forgery is uncaught. All forgery are caught.
Yes, sir, thank you. Now the next question is, do handwriting really tell about the inner personality of a person or just their state of mind during that time of writing?
Both. We can understand at the time of writing, what is his emotional state? Today he is unhappy, today he is sad, or today he is angry. That is moment to moment emotions. and the personality type, which is genetic, which is even the long past he has been carrying. So it is a fixed character, it is a temporary character, it is a changeable character, all reflects in one handwriting, and graphologist can separate it.
Okay, sir. Now the next question is, why do doctors in general have bad handwritings, or they just do it intentionally? Shall I repeat it, sir?
No. I reserve this question because many doctors have excellent handwriting. A few doctors may have bad handwriting. May have. Yes, I have seen also. And that is their character.
Okay, sir.
That is their character. And that is exactly, that is taught in our graphology basic course. Ki when someone writes this type of medical certificate, this is to certify that. So if this is the medical certificate we teach, what is the meaning of this handwriting?
Okay, sir. The next
question. Yes, they have their characters, but most doctors have good handwritings. And nowadays it has become a rule that your signature must be on prescription in the government hospital, must be very legible so that it can identify who has written or not.
Okay, next. Sir. Thank you. How does a cancer patient's handwriting differ from others?
How does
a cancer patient's handwriting differ from other?
I will have to show, and that what we teach in our graphology course, I cannot even in the online, it is very difficult you to show, but I would have shown you. You know, what is cancer, if you understand that, as I told you, understand. I will explain a little bit. Suppose you are an anxiety-prone person. And your anxiety increases as the days goes ahead. Or maybe in the morning, your anxiety is high and goes low afterwards. But gradually, your anxiety is increasing. And in the anxiety, there is a secretion, the chemical secretion, the hormonal secretion called cortisol. And excessive anxiety actually helps to create histamine. And there is an allergic reaction in the body. So if I see high level of anxiety in one handwriting, that level is also can be measured in handwriting, quantitative measurement. And we can easily see that allergy or skin disease from the handwriting, because there is a direct relationship between the anxiety, histamine, and allergic reaction. Similar things in the cancer also, the reverse. When there is a cell growth, it put an impact on your nervous system, and it put an impact on your emotional state. And so motor catches those. And when motor catches those, in the writing stroke, there will be a fine changes in the ink density in the writing stroke. And accurate level. I will give one example, you believe or don't believe. One of my faculty in our Kolkata Institute of Graphology, his father was diagnosed as cancer in 2018. Sir, may know, yeah, Dr. Kaur, that faculty. So his father was diagnosed as cancer, prostate cancer. He was in down, low mood. So he came, I told, bring the handwriting. Handwriting was brought. Unbelievable for you, but this is true. I saw the handwriting and found no cancer. No cancer means no cancer. I told, be confident, your father doesn't have any cancer. So he took to Hyderabad, no cancer. He took to Chennai, no cancer. machine can fail, but handwriting will not betray, because handwriting originates from motor cortex, and motor cortex catches the finest movement of the body. And someone who is in the brain science here, he will know that in the brain neuron at the top, the finest frequencies are caught, which is called fine motor. And finest the frequency, longer is sustainability. That is, more the frequencies are finest, the handwriting catches it. And that is why unmistakable evidence is reflected in the handwriting about cancer or any diseases. I have given just one example. It is there. Next.
Next question is, clear writing and untidy writing reveals same thing or only the pattern?
Pardon? Question clear repeat, writing, please.
Yes, sir. Clear writing clear and writing. Untidy. Sorry, sir.
I understood. Clear writing and untidy writing.
Untidy writing.
Yes.
Reveals same thing or only the pattern?
In handwriting analysis, the word untidy or a clear writing. Now, untidy in what respect? Illegible, clumsy. Suppose I write, I go to school. So this can be an untidy writing. Yes, this is graphologically, we separate, we understand where actually the problems are. And when you talk of a well-organized writing, I go to school. So well-organized writing, here also we understand where the strengths and weaknesses are. Here we understand where the strengths and weaknesses are. So even an untidy writing also have some strengths. And even a very well-organized writing also have some weaknesses. So we see the writing, whether untidy or tidy, or well-organized, we understand the strengths and weaknesses from the parts of the writing. Both are not same definitely. And it is also our concern, untidy part by part. That is, this is untidy, that is, he has written two like this. Yes, untidy in respect of T and O. Someone writes G-O and 2-O. So untidy in respect of line space, that is, he jumbled up two lines. Anyone whose handwriting actually jumbled up two lines, here at present, many of your writing is there. I go to school every day. Then, so if your both line touches like that, you are of that person who plans too many activities and jumble up. You will appreciate it. And you are a person who wants to solve everything just now. You have a person who has a low frustration tolerance. Like that. So untidy where is our concern, and accordingly we interpret. Thank you. Next question.
বাংলাতে আছে আর কি আমার হ্যান্ডরাইটিং প্রতি মোমেন্টে চেঞ্জ হয় এর মানে কি
কোথায় চেঞ্জ হয় সেটা তো আমাকে দেখতে হবে প্রথমে আপনি দেখেন হ্যান্ডরাইটিং চেঞ্জ হয় কোথায় চেঞ্জ হয় সাইজে চেঞ্জ হয় আপনি লিখছেন আমার আপনি তারপরের মুহূর্তে লিখছেন মনে হয় তারপরে আবার হয়টা বড় করছেন কোথায় চেঞ্জ হয় দ্যাট গ্রাফোলজি সি যদি দেখা যায় সাইজ বড় ছোট হচ্ছে বড় হচ্ছে ছোট হয়ে যাচ্ছে বড় হচ্ছে ছোট হয়ে যাচ্ছে ইউ আর সাফারিং ফ্রম কনফিউশন অ্যাবাউট লাইফস্টাইল অর দ্য চোজেন ফিল্ড অফ ওয়ার্ক মানে অকুপেশন নিয়ে এবং লাইফ নিয়ে কনফিউশন চলছে যদি সাইজ বড় ছোট হতে থাকে আর যদি দেখা যায় যে স্ল্যান্ট চেঞ্জ হচ্ছে তাহলে আবার আর একটা অ্যাসপেক্ট মানে এরকম যদি কেউ লেখে আবার আর একটা অ্যাসপেক্ট মানে আপনার কোথায় হ্যান্ডরাইটিং চেঞ্জ হচ্ছে সেটা তো গ্রাফোলজিস্ট জানে কারণ কোথায় হ্যান্ডরাইটিং চেঞ্জ অ্যাকর্ডিংলি তার ইন্টারপ্রিটেশনস আছে সেটা না দেখলে তো আমি বলতে পারবো না
ওকে স্যার থ্যাংক ইউ থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার দিস আর অল ফর টুডে সো এন্ড উই আর অনার্ড টু হ্যাভ ইউ ইন দি ইন দিস ওয়েবিনার স্যার থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ
ভেরি মাচ Thank you.
Now I would like to hand over this session to our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Sushandra Chatterjee, ma'am, for the vote of thanks. Over to you, Dr. Chatterjee.
Thank you, Dr. Mondol. Am I audible?
I'm not Mondol, I'm Bose.
No, I was talking about Prashanno.
Sorry.
So, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to you all for choosing to be with us in today's webinar, Introduction to Graphology and its Implication in Society. It is an honor to us that you have opted to be here instead of having a lunch at your home now. Now we have come to the end of this lively virtual gathering. And before we wind up, just a few words of warmth and gratitude. You know, saying thank you is more than good manners. It is actually good spirituality. And I'm really privileged to get this opportunity of delivering vote of thanks in this webinar. On behalf of IQAC Surendranath College, my first and foremost duty is to express my sincerest gratitude to Mr. Mohan Bose for gracing this occasion, sharing his valuable time, and enriching us with his most interesting and informative speech. Mr. Bose, your content today has definitely helped the audience to understand how the physical characteristics and patterns of handwriting can identify the psychological state of the author at the time of writing and also evaluating his or her personality. This knowledge may help us to change our personality by changing our handwriting. Thank you, sir, for coming here and delivering this thought-provoking address. I am immensely grateful to the college authority, the governing body, for their motivation and support. A special mention to our respected principal, Dr. Indru Nilkor, for his pivotal role in organizing this program. Thank you, sir, for steering this webinar from the day one. Sincere thanks are due to my amazing colleagues, both teaching and non-teaching. It is always a pleasure to work every day with such lovely and engaging people. I compliment the devoted members of our technical team for their real hard work, sincerity, and tenacity. Dear members, I cannot thank every one of you enough for your involvement and dedication, even in this lockdown period. I also thank all our loving students for showing great interest in this webinar. Their spontaneous presence, no doubt, has made today's program really meaningful. And last but not the least, I thank again all the valued viewers. We owe you a lot for being with us in this webinar. Without your active participation, this event would not have been possible. Right. So with these, it's time to conclude. And I would conclude with a high hope for better, more beautiful days ahead after COVID. Just keep pressing on. All stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Before you leave the meeting room, two quick announcements. One is regarding the feedback form. The feedback link, as you can see, is available in the chat box and also in the college website. Please, please do fill the feedback form by 5th July, 2 p.m. And carefully fill the feedback form because according to that, you will be getting your e-certificates. So this was the first announcement. And the second announcement is regarding our upcoming webinars. Today at 4:30, we have the second installment of this international webinar where Ms. Srijoni Dash is going to speak about the latest updates of COVID-19 vaccine and the susceptibility of elderly people. Tomorrow, again, we have a very interesting webinar to be organized by Department of Zoology under the DBT Star Strengthening Scheme, where Dr. Shivabroto Banerjee is going to speak on COVID-19 testing and modeling perspective. The talk is from 1 to 2 p.m. So please be there. And on 6th, we have another interesting webinar which is organized by Department of Chemistry, again under the DBT Star Strengthening Scheme. And here our beloved speaker, Dr. Sudeep Pal, is going to speak on academics versus industry, choosing the right path. So the students who are in academics, who are seeing now no hope in this dire pandemic situation, I hope this webinar will give you some ray of hope at least. So stay tuned, stay with us, stay safe. Thank you.